Hello and welcome everybody. I'm One Proud Bavarian and you might know me from my Grand Strategy channel here on YouTube. I'm collaborating with Paradox Interactive to bring you a series of tutorial videos about Crusader Kings 3. In this video I want to focus on how you can build and lead your dynasty to greatness. Half a century ago, Charlemagne's empire ruled over Western Europe, but it has since been split into East Francia, Lotharingia, Italy and West Francia, all ruled by members of the Carling dynasty. West Francia is under the control of Charles the Bold, and he will serve as our example for this video. I'll be telling you about marriages and alliances, prestige and fame, cadet branches, and last but not least, renown and legacies. Let's kick it off by talking about marriages and alliances. Marriages in this time period are very rarely motivated by love. You will mostly be looking for marriages to bind your fate to other powerful families. It is important to note that commonly the children of a marriage will belong to the father's house and dynasty. This is reversed if both sides agree to a matrilineal marriage. The most direct benefit of marriages, besides the children stemming from it, are alliances. Both the spouses as well as their close relatives will become allied, which is how you will acquire most of your alliances. Usually this means that both sides will aid one another in war, but it can also have other benefits. Charles the Bold has married his daughter Judith to the Duke of Flanders. For the moment it means that the Duke of Flanders will never join a faction against Charles, no matter how much the mood has soured. Charles needs his own kingdom to stay at peace, since he plans to go to war over the rest of the Carolingian Empire. Now that you know how to keep your dynasty going, let's take a look at prestige and fame, which measure the success of your character. Prestige is accumulated over time based on your actions, the titles you hold, and your personality. You can use prestige in many different ways. If you were to press Charles' claims to the rest of the empire, you would have to expend some of your prestige, for example. Whether you spend it or not, every bit of prestige you accumulate counts towards your level of fame. The higher it is, the higher will people think of you. This, of course, makes ruling significantly easier. Be careful about your own reputation. If you act dishonorably, for example by breaking a truce, your hard-earned fame will melt away like snow in summer, and people will begin looking at you differently. Prestige and fame make for a good measure of how well an individual character is doing, but what truly matters in Crusader Kings 3 is the family. Let's continue by talking about cadet branches. A dynasty is a group of nobles that all trace their lineage back to one common ancestor. With time, as the dynasty grows, rulers that want more power within the dynasty might found their own branches. These branches are also called houses, and they still belong to the same dynasty. Founding a new house, however, brings more independence, more direct power over house members, and it comes with the opportunity to rise up to be recognized as the new dynasty head. Becoming and remaining the dynasty head requires you to be the most powerful head of a house inside of your dynasty. Let's take a look at why being the dynasty head is absolutely amazing. Renown and legacies are the next and last topic, and they measure the success of your dynasty as a whole. Renown increases over time based on the current titles family members hold and the total number of living dynasty members. It is a powerful boon that the dynasty's head can spend on influencing their family directly or by investing it in legacies. Legacies give permanent bonuses to your dynasty and reflect the history of your ancestors. The choice between influencing your dynasty directly or via legacies can be a tough one, since they both require renown. Every accumulated point of renown also earns your dynasty splendor, which widens the range of resources and options your family has. A well-respected dynasty will, for example, have it easier to keep a realm under control, even in hard times. The more your family grows, the more all of you will benefit from your dynasty legacies. However, it will also become more likely that infighting will become a common sight. Play your cards right, and you will be able to guide your family through the centuries as their leader. Play your cards wrong, however, and your dynasty will be lost in history. Thank you for tuning in to today's CK3 tutorial about dynasties. Next time we'll take a look at succession and how you can keep your realm from the fate of the Carolingian Empire. Make sure to subscribe to this channel so that you don't miss the next tutorial video. For now, later, alligator.